Hello and welcome to Movie Maniac. And today we're counting down our picks for the top 3 best movies that represents every communication model. In this list, we're gonna talk about some of the functions and uses of every communication model. Number 3. Shannon Weaver Model. Known as the mother of all communication models, it depicts communication as a linear or one-way process. However, it has been criticized for missing an essential element called feedback, even though it has elements like source, transmitter, channel, receiver, and destination. Without feedback, the speaker will not know whether the receiver understands the message or not. In this scene of Stranger Things Season 1, Episode 7, it shows the Shannon Weaver model as presented. Lucas is calling his friend Mike and Dustin on a walkie-talkie, but because he is riding a bike while talking to them, and due to the poor signal, he becomes choppy, which causes Dustin and Mike to not clearly understand what Lucas is saying. This signifies Lucas as the source, the walkie-talkie as the transmitter, and also Dustin and Mike as the receivers who didn't give any feedback because of the barrier or so-called noise source, which is because of the poor signal.
Guys, it's Lucas. I think he's in trouble. Do you remember how he said he was looking for the gate?
Yeah.
What if he found it?
What's he saying?
I don't know. He's way out of range.
Lucas, if you can hear us, slow down. We can't understand you. Yes! I copy! Do you? They know about 11! Get in there! They know about 11! The bad men are coming! All of them! Do you hear me? The bad men are coming!
Mad Hand, does that mean anything to you? Like a code name or something?
Moving at number 2. Transaction model. It is a two-way process with the inclusion of feedback as an element. Unlike the Shannon Weaver model, this model involves the more interactive and collaborative exchange of messages between communicators with an aim of understanding each other. It also shows that there are multiple barriers or so-called noise that may interfere with the flow of communication. In their conversation was an example of a transaction model in the movie A Quiet Place. In this scene, Lee Abbott and his son Marcus Abbott were participants. At first, they are only communicating with hand signs or nonverbal communication to avoid making noise sounds, which would make them hunted by the monsters that were nearby. But when they got to the falls nearby to catch fish, they were able to communicate verbally. The falls was a great example of multiple physical sound barrier between them, not only their conversation, but also between them and the monsters, preventing them from hearing them because of the splashes coming through the falls. A transaction model can be also an example that noise isn't necessarily a distraction when communicating.
Why didn't you let her come? Do you blame her?
And at number 1, Scram Model. You're probably wondering what makes the Scram Model different from the other two. Well, the Scram Model is the modified version of the Shannon Weaver model and is also similar to the transaction model because of its element called feedback. However, it only contains one noise barrier, but some elements are improved, such as sender, encoder, signal, decoder, and receiver. But there was another element that was added in this model, which is the field of experience, which clearly talks about the knowledge or the experience of each other about the topic of the sender and receiver. When Russell comes knocking on Mr. Fredrickson's door in this scene from Up, he's being sent away. Mr. Fredrickson, the encoder of the message, sends and encodes his message of non-interest and unwillingness by saying that Russell must first find the bird in his neighborhood.
Yep, then I'll be a senior wilderness.
wilderness explorer.
You ever heard of a snipe?
Snipe?
Bird. Beady eyes. Every night it sneaks in my yard and gobbles my poor azaleas. I'm elderly and infirm. I can't catch it. If only someone could help me.
Me! I'll do it!
Oh, I don't know. It's awfully crafty. You'd have to clap your hands 3 times to lure it in.
I'll find them, Mr. Fredrickson.
I think its burrow's 2 blocks down.
If you 2 blocks past... down, got it!
Mr. Fredrickson's intention here is to drive Russell away, and Russell, on the other hand, decodes as this way to help the elderly and to get his badge, so he complied with the order. In this scene, Mr. Fredrickson's intention was not clear to Russell, and so Russell misinterpreted the message. And that's it for today's video. If you like this kind of content, make sure to like and subscribe to be notified to our latest videos.